So, remember at the beginning of this unit when I introduced you to non-determinism and the if-better function? And we also talked about simulating the if-better function and how this takes exponential time to do. And I imagine your first reaction to this might have been a mild version of so what, or even this is ridiculous. But now, think what this means in the context of NP-completeness. If for any NP-complete problem, you find a deterministic algorithm that runs in polynomial time, then you have also found a way to simulate a non-deterministic RAM in polynomial time, which would mean that a normal deterministic RAM without the if-better function is just as powerful as one that has this function, which of course seems a bit strange because our intuition of course tells us that having this if-better function is super, super powerful and should somehow make a difference. So the cool thing is there's only two possibilities. Either all NP-complete problems can be solved in polynomial time, which would essentially mean that P equals NP. So any problem that can be solved in polynomial time on a non-deterministic RAM can be solved in polynomial time on a deterministic RAM. Or in other words, a deterministic RAM is just as powerful as a non-deterministic one. Or there could be the other case, and that is no NP-complete problem can be solved in polynomial time, so P does not equal NP. There are certain problems that you can solve in polynomial time if you have the if-better function available, but you cannot solve them in polynomial time if you don't have this function. So basically you'd say P does not equal NP is the same as saying that the if-better function is really powerful. So which one is it? And that question is the famous P versus NP problem. Because the thing is, we don't know. Nobody knows. Asking this question here, if P equals NP or P does not equal NP, is a problem that is decades old, and yet nobody has been able to figure it out. Now, given how powerful this if-better function is, remember when I introduced it to you, it seemed like this magic function that could solve all of our problems. Many computer scientists nowadays believe that P does not equal NP, but nobody has been able to prove it. On the other hand, also nobody has been able to find a polynomial time algorithm for any single NP-complete problem, despite literally thousands of practically relevant NP-complete problems being out there. Now let's think a little bit of how you could resolve this question. So how could you show that P equals NP or P does not equal NP? And we'll do that as a quiz. So I'm going to give you a number of accomplishments or things that you could do. And I would like you to tell me what would that show. So for example, if you found a polynomial time algorithm for an NP-complete problem, would that show that P equals NP? Would that show that P does not equal NP? Or would that show nothing interesting? And what if you found an algorithm that solves an NP-complete problem in polynomial time on average? So not worst case running time, but average case running time. And what about if you showed that the most efficient algorithm for click requires exponential time, on a deterministic RAM, of course? Would that show that P equals NP, P does not equal NP, or something else, or we don't know? What if you showed that the vertex cover problem has an exponential number of potential solutions that any algorithm has to go through? What if you were able to reduce the click problem to the shortest path problem? So shortest path is finding the shortest path between two vertices in a graph. What if you were to reduce click to the problem of finding the shortest path between two vertices in a graph? Or what if you could show that any shortest path problem in a graph can be solved by solving click in a transformed graph? So please make your selection, which ones are correct.